Children, today we are going to start the solution of exercise 3.2. Now, before we start the solution, let us discuss a little bit about the graph. See, graph, you can see there is a big square. You can see a big square. Yes or not? As I am marking, you can see this is a big square. And inside this big square, you can see a light line that divides that big square into four equal parts, and each equal part is five small squares. So how many small squares inside a big square? There are 10 small squares inside a big square. Okay, 10 small squares. Whenever we select the scale, we select the scale by choosing the small square, not the big small square. Okay, not big square. It is rather we select by small square. Okay, now let us see the question. First of all, it is given that in the exercise 3.2, if you see, what is the horizontal line? Horizontal line is nothing but you see x o x dash. So what is the horizontal line? Horizontal line is your x-axis. Horizontal line is your x-axis. And then next, what is that? Vertical line. This is the vertical line. This is the vertical line. So vertical line is known as y-axis. Vertical line is known as y-axis. Then determine the, okay, next, what is the name of each plane formed by these two lines? Remember, I have explained in my last class also that this is a two-dimensional. As it is a two-dimensional, that the x-axis and y-axis, this is x-axis and this is y-axis and this is x-axis, and these two divide the plane into four parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. But one thing is that it is anti-clockwise direction, that is not clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction means it is going this way, it is going this way, it is not clockwise, anti-clockwise. If clockwise will come from left to right, and if it is anti-clockwise, you will go right to left. Okay, so then that is the x-axis and y-axis. Now before each part of this plane divided by the two axes is known as quadrant. And after that, before I go to the next one, see, the AXIS is the singular form. AXIS is the singular form, and AXES is the plural form of the word AXIS. So what is the plural form? AXES. And what is the singular form? AXIS. Okay? Now let's see, in the next, write the name of the point where these two lines intersect. What is the point of intersection of the two lines? Point of intersection of the two lines is known as, point of intersection of the two lines is known as origin. See, this is the line, this is another line, intersect each other at O. And what is the coordinate of origin? 0, 0. Coordinate of the origin is 0, 0. Okay. Now, next, you see, in the next one is that question number 2. Question number 2, if you see what they are asking, coordinate of B, what is your B? This is, let's say B, this is your B. So B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So x-axis or abscissa is minus 5. And what is the coordinate? 1, 2. So what is the coordinate of B? Coordinate of B is minus 5, 2. Okay, next, you see, coordinate of C. What is your C? Coordinate of C. Coordinate is, abscissa is 5, and ordinate is also 5, but that is minor. So, it is 5, minus 5. Next, the point identified by the coordinates, minus 3, minus 5. So E is the coordinate. E is the coordinate point whose coordinate is minus 3, minus 5. Next, you see point identified by coordinates 2, minus 4. 2, minus 4. So, 2, this is 1, 2, 2, minus 4, minus 4. So, G. So, what is the coordinate of G? G is 2, minus 4. Next, the abscis of the point D. Abscis of the point D is abscis of the point D. D. What is your D? Find out D. This is your D. See, abscis is 6. Ordinate is 2. So, 6, 2. And abscis is 6. What is abscis? Here, abscis is 6. Next, ordinate of the point H. What is H? H. H, what is the coordinate? Minus 5, minus 3. Minus 5, minus 3. So, ordinate is minus 3. Then next, they are asking, what is the coordinate of the point L? What is your L? L is this one. And on y-axis, remember, on y-axis, coordinate abscis is 0. And on x-axis, ordinate is 0. So, here, 0, 5. And then, what is the coordinates of point M? Point M is, what is your M? M, let's say M. What is your M? M is this one. So, minus 3, 0 lies on x-axis. Clear? So, this is the end of this exercise. Now, before I wind up from this class, please see this graph. Please see this graph. Here I have given some points. A, B, C, D, then E. E is this one. Then E, F. F is this one. And then G. G is this one. And then, so these are the points I have given you. So please see. Coordinate. You have to find out the coordinate of B. You have to find out the coordinate of B. So, coordinate of B, you calculate and find out. Then you have to find out the coordinate of A. Then you have to find out coordinate of C. You have to find out the coordinate of D. D is where? Where is your D? D. This is your D. Then coordinate of E. Coordinate of E. Coordinate of F. Coordinate of F. Coordinate of G. This is your G. Coordinate of H. Where is H? H. So these all the coordinate you have to take out. Okay. Then next you see, find the abscis of B, D, and G. Find the abscis of B, D, and G. The next question number 3. Find the coordinate of A, C, H, and G. A, C, H, and G. And next coordinate of the origin is dash. Coordinate of the origin is dash. So with this, I'll wind up from this time, and then next we'll start with the next exercise. Okay, till that time, bye bye. See you next class.